Welcome everyone to another Star Wars The Old Republic video, and I am back. After about 4 to 5 months of taking a little bit of a hiatus, I am now going to start doing semi-regular uploads of some SWTOR YouTube videos. I'm also going to be streaming on Twitch a little bit, maybe going for 1 to 2 hours a few days a week, just doing some PvP and chatting with you guys. The link to my Twitch channel will be in the description. And now, you know, before I didn't have a lot of time, but now all I've got is time, and I just want to get back into this game that I love and making content for you guys, and I'm really excited about it. So hope you guys are excited as well. But you might be wondering what has brought me back. Well, the simple answer is cartel items. The PTS got released or went live a few weeks ago, and they had some new cartel items, and they actually look pretty darn neat. And so I just want to make a quick video about them, showcasing some of the items. And I myself am a little bit excited. I want to get you guys excited, because that if that isn't my job, I don't know what is. It used to be a big part of my channel, and I want to get back into it. What can I say? I love SWTOR Barbie, and I'm not ashamed to admit it. All right. So we'll start with the ugliest armor set first. This one is the Wayward Voyager's armor set. Yes, you're getting all my opinions unfiltered now. This one is, it's nothing too special about it. I like fancy, flashy stuff, and this one definitely isn't fancy nor flashy. It's got an upper body armor that's a little bit cool. It has this Jedi robe-like feel to it, and maybe it would look good on a Jedi. So the upper body armor is alright, but the helmet just seems to be a reskin of some bronze stuff we already have. There's nothing too special about the gloves or the boots from what I can see. So yeah, I think the upper body armor is the highlight of this one, but it seems to be one of those sort of throwaway armor sets. Like BioWare tends to release these silver rarity armor sets that they just put up, and there's nothing too special about them, so it's definitely, you know, seems to be one of those types. The next one is a lot nicer. This one is the Mandalorian Stormbringer's armor set. So yes, another Mandalorian armor set. BioWare definitely wants to sort of capitalize on the Mandalorian craze that's going on right now, and they're doing a pretty good job of it. This one is pretty neat. It adds this new sort of helmet design to the game that we do not have, and we don't really have anything like this. It's very reminiscent of the Mythosaurus logo that's on a lot of the Mandalorian memorabilia, as well as their flag and everything like that. I'll throw up a picture to show you guys. The Mythosaurus is the beast from Mandalorian mythology, and so it seems to be inspired by that. It's also very similar to a lot of the Viking helmets that existed in the past, so it's definitely going off that whole warrior culture design. No doubt it's meant to intimidate your opponents and stuff. But the helmet is the real selling point of this one. It even has a flare associated with it. So when you enter combat stance, you will have a little green hologram show up over your eye. And so that's pretty cool as well. But in terms of the rest of the armor set, it's all right. It's got this cool armor plating. I'm not a big fan of the red, gray, and green sort of design. I don't think those colors go too well together. But it would have been so much cooler if it was just only red or something. But of course, you could dye the armor set and make it whatever color you want. I'm not a big fan of the boots. They don't match, and they just seem too bulky. It has a jetpack on the back. That's pretty cool. It's going to look pretty good with rocket boost and stuff like that. So yeah, overall, all in all, pretty neat armor set. The next item is my favorite. This is the Basilisk War Mount. Now, for those of you who are super fans of my channel, you will know a few years back, I made a SWTOR wish list. And on this wish list, I had a picture of Mandalore the Ultimate actually riding one of these mounts. And I said that mount looks so cool, and it would be really neat if they added it into the game. And I never once thought it would actually happen. But I guess BioWare decided that they wanted to capitalize on the whole Mandalorian craze. And yeah, they're actually adding one of these mounts into the game, and it looks really neat. It definitely doesn't look as good as it looks in the photo or the fan image, but of course it's not. The game always makes them look different. But yeah, it still looks really cool. There's a couple of things I really like about this one. And the first one is its size. Like, it's massive. Look at the character model at the top in relation to the actual beast of a mount. Like, it's huge. It's got this perfect blend of looking like a beast, but of course it has the machine components to it. And it even has a flare. So when you activate the mount flourish, it will fire the guns at the side. So all in all, it looks really cool. I kind of hope they make it have a little bit more finesse. And maybe change up the color a little bit in the final game model, but yeah, it looks really cool. All right, the next item is a mount, and this one is the Advanced Scout Walker. Now, we have quite a lot of Walker mounts in the game, but a lot of the Walker ones that we have are based off of the design during the time of the Empire. And this one is very much during the time of the Clone Wars. It's what the clones used to ride into battle, where it's more of just like a little bit of a vehicle, and the whole top part is very exposed. It would be cool if they had a flourish with this one where it fires the front guns. That would be pretty neat. But all in all, definitely inspired from the Clone Wars, and yeah, I think it's a cool addition to the whole Walker series. And the final item is the Ancient Jedi Blade. Now this one is the second most that I'm excited for. It's a really neat vibrosword, and I'm a sucker for vibroswords in general, but this one has some really cool elements to it. I think the first one is that it's the first melee weapon to actually come with its own holster. So we already have the guns like Mischief and Anarchy, which they create their own holsters on your character. But this one is actually gonna have a holster on your shoulder. So it's gonna get stored kind of like a katana on your back. And it just has this really cool tribic rustic feel to it, something like a Tithonian Jedi Master would use back on Tython or something. It's kind of held together very rustically, so that's really neat. I think it's going to look great with a couple of tunings. It just is such an awesome, unique weapon. We don't have the rarity at the moment, but it's probably going to be platinum rarity, maybe gold. We've seen some cool gold items get released in the past, but definitely expected to be an expensive one, both on the cartel market and on the GTN, but it's going to be a really cool addition to the Vibroswords. And that concludes my first video back. I hope you guys enjoyed it. I definitely enjoy making SWTOR content, so I'm excited to get back into it as well. Just to make a quick note, my last video was actually looking at some of the upcoming cartel market items as well, and in that video we had a lot of Mandalorian items directly from the TV show, but some of those have not made it into the game yet, so I don't really know when they're gonna come. We haven't seen the Mandalorian, the character, his guns come into the game yet, so I'm pretty excited for those. But aside from that, we did see like Tower Deer's armor set and some of the other stuff that was previewed there make it into the game. So the bottom line is we don't actually know when this stuff's going to come in. I'm thinking maybe with the new update with the whole swoop racing that's coming in and stuff, they're probably going to release some of these, but maybe all of them. Who knows? I'm just waiting for that Basilisk War mount. That's the one I'm most excited for. Hope you guys enjoyed the video. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section, and I will see you guys in the next one.